Mountains crest where wings fly free, just like our imagination. So I wanted to get on today and do like a let's whip it together Wednesday and do just a little quick project. Something that is, it was really quick to work up, and it just, I don't know, to me it really makes your hats that you can create on your adding machine or your Centro or whatever knit machine that you have, it just gives it a whole new look. I don't know why my light keeps going off. My phone had an update and I'm not happy with it. Ugh, my camera settings are all wonky. Everything's wonky today. And I don't know what's going on. So anyway, so these are your typical hats that you can knit on your machine. Oh my goodness. So this right here is the Karen Ogo Halo yarn. And let me tell you what, if you can get your hands on it, do so. Because this knits up like a dream. I mean, like a dream. No snags, no, like, you know, sometimes your machine can like lose a stitch. Nothing like that. Nothing like that. And it's so super stretchy. So, so soft. I want like a full-blown sweater out of this. This is just, I love this. But this is really, really stretchy. So anyway, this is just your, you know, normal hat. And of course, you can fold up, you know, your ends and make yourself like a big, thicker brim. You can add a pom-pom. Add a little tag to it and, you know, call it a day. But I wanted to do something that would, you know, break the box open and get you out of that, you know, regular hat. Especially if you're going, you know, craft fair season is coming up. Fall is right around the corner and so is winter. And so you're going to be making all your hats and things like that. And if you have a machine, you know, this is a way that gives you a little oomph to your hat, makes you stand out a little bit more than the, you know, if you're going to go to a craft fair and there's somebody else that has hats, you know, they're all going to look the same. And that's not an issue. I mean, that's nice. Sometimes, you know, you can add stripes to this. You can do different things to this. Add one of those little tag thingies to it and stuff like that. But, you know, this is just going to give your hats a whole new look. So I'm going to show you how we do it, but first I'm going to show you the hats. So I call it noshay, which is crochet and knit, or knit and crochet. The hat is knitted on the machine and the brim is crocheted, but it just gives it, I'm telling you, when you see this, it gives it a whole new look. And I just love it. So here is one of the hats. So this part is knitted. This is Yarn Bee. I forget the name of it, but it's a Hobby Lobby yarn. Then I have a pom-pom. But here it is with the brim. Look at that. So this is crocheted. I used the Karen Ogo. I just said it too. Karen Ogo. Oh my gosh. Halo yarn. There we go. My brain. And then I just added a little tag that says let it snow. And then I just added like a little blue little trim around it. Because I just thought that was so pretty. But look how, like, even without this. I can just flip it to the back. Even without this, look how pretty it makes your hat. It just makes it stand out and pop. Now, like I said, I know that you can take your knitted hat and you can add a different color to it. And all you have to do is just, you know, you can add a different color down here. And then you can flip it up. But this just gives a whole new look. Because this is crocheted, it just brings two worlds together. And just gives it a whole new look. And I love it. So here's this one. Oh, my little... I'll get that all later. Everything this side of the fall. This is, you can barely see it, but it says it's just a bunch of hocus pocus. So on this tag, I'm going to do it differently. I'm going to bring this out more. I thought the black would really have popped on there, but it gets kind of lost, so I'm going to go over it with some, maybe glitter or something that's going to be brighter that really pop that out. But here is this hat. And so this is the knitted on the machine, and then this is the brim. And just look how it just gives a whole new look to the hat. This I did one layer. So it's just one thinness layer when the other ones, you know, they're the two when you like put it inside each other, and you get like a double thickness. Well, this one I just had enough and I just did the one layer. I just wanted to see how it was going to turn out. Anyway, but here's a pom-pom. Oh, the pom-poms are removable. They have a little snap to it. And so, there we go. Look how cute that one looks. This one has to be, I don't know which one has to be my favorite. I really don't, because I say it and then I see it, the other ones, and I'm like, don't know. So, but this one's so funny. So this one, it says, oh snap, and then you see a little gingerbread, and he has a little leg snap, and his little face is like, oh no, sounding like Mickey Mouse. But again, this is the Karen Ogo Halo yarn. I think I was able to make 3 or 4 hats out of this one, and then do the brims. So then this is a Hobby Lobby yarn. Is my flashlight not on? Yes, it's on. It's a Hobby Lobby yarn. Oh. Yarn Bee, I think it's called like Oats. But I love it. I really love it. And then I just went around the edges with some fur. And then add a little fur pom-pom. And so then there that hat is. But isn't it so cute? I'm telling you right now. It just gives a whole new look to your machine knitted hats. It really, really does. I've been really going crazy with these machine knitted hats and just added like little brims to it. And like I said, you can add that or not, because either way, it still looks cute. See, even without a little tag, it still looks cute. So I did these, and didn't put tags on yet. I'm going to. I just started making some, but here's this one. This is, I love this yarn print. I forget the color. I want to say sunshine, but I forget. But then again, here is, I'm telling you, this yarn, I really, really love the Halo yarn. It just really makes a nice brim. But there you go. You can just add a pom-pom to this and go about your day. Or even just like this. Just like this is cute. This one's going to be Kennergy, because everybody loves that Barbie movie. I have yet to see it. I don't want to see it. But I know everybody's loving the Kennergy. So I thought I was going to make a tag and put like Kennergy there and like a big pink pom-pom or something. And just, you know, have something be cute. But this is, do I have it over here? No, I don't. I'm sorry. I forget what this is. But it's a thicker yarn. But look how nice that looks. Let me move this one out of the way. Oh, this right here. Oh my goodness. This is luscious too. Okay, so this is Eco Brights from Michaels. I have a bunch of it. And I thought I used it all up. I really did. And then when I was cleaning out the craft room and rearranging everything, I found a bunch. And I was like, ugh, I have so much of this, you know. And then I was like, you know what, let me see how this knits up on the machine. Oh my goodness, I'm so happy I didn't, like, just put it out for free or something. Because it works up like butter. Like, it just goes so, like, you can't even hear it as you're working it up. It just goes so fast and so, so soft. And really, really stretchy. Like, oh, this is another one I want, like, in a full-blown knitted sweater. Like, this is so stretchy, so soft. Mr. Hoot is having me make him a whole bunch of little beanies out of this. He stole a couple. I was working on some. He's like, oh, these for me, because he knows I'm making beanies every year. So he's so happy. So I just thought, well, you know what? I have plenty. So one of the skeins make Yeah, two full hats. It might make more if you did it thinner, but you know, this is the thick one where you put the, you know how you put the hats together and you sew it at the end to put the long pieces inside. But oh, but look, look how you can just add a pom-pom and that's it. But look at the thicker yarn. It just gives like this, oh, so wintry and fall. Like, I love hats like that with a nice brim. Now, usually I love a knitted brim. I always said that before over crochet. But with these hats, I'm going to say I love the crocheted brim. So this one right here, again, this is the Eco Brights. And, oh, it's so soft. This is, I think, I forget, baby blue or something like that. Or mint. I think this was mint, even though it looks like Tiffany blue. And then this one is a Hobby Lobby yarn. It has like some shimmer to it. But I thought that was so pretty with this. I'm going to put a baby, it's cold outside, and then a big pom-pom on this. But like I said, you can just keep it like this and it will be beautiful. Another thing you can do, which I don't have it over here, but I'm starting to do, is you can embroider on top of this. So that's going to be a next one that we do together. I'm going to teach you how to embroider on top of your knitted hats so you can, you know, really pop them out even more. So those are the hats. I'm going to use this one today and a 6.5 crochet hook. And then I have two yarns. I have the Eco Brights in white. And then I have that cream. It's a Hobby Lobby yarn. I'm so sorry. But look at that shimmer in there. So let me pull my yarn and get it ready. And then I'm going to show you how to go around this. Because there is a trick to it. You don't want to just go in every single stitch. I'm so sorry. Or your hat brim was going to be huge. So let me get everything ready and I'll get back in the hoop. Alrighty. I'll zoom you in a little bit. So here is the bottom of your hat. And right here are your stitches. And if you look closely, there's like one bump and two bump. So right in between those two bumps is where you want to go when you're putting a stitch. Okay, so every time you're putting a stitch, you want to go right between the two bumps. Let me show you here. So right here, there's one bump and there's two bump. And this is, you know, the bottom of the hat. And then there's, again, there's that one bump and two. And you want to go right in between here. So every time you go around into the stitches, you want to make sure you have two bumps. And you're going in between. All the way around. Now, your knitted machine, depending on which one you have, will have like 40 pegs. And, you know, so you're going to be having more stitches. So you don't want to go around in every single stitch right here. Because if you think about it, it's going to have, it's 40 pegs, but the in-between stitch, so it's going to really be 80 stitches, okay? So you don't want to have a brim of 80 stitches because then your hat will be like really out here, your brim will be out here and it's going to look wonky. So what I do and what I figured is the best is I go in every pull in yarn. Okay. So I go in every fourth stitch. So I'm going to show you right here. So I just looped my first one in and you're just going to tie that in. Don't do this. and go through your stitches, because this will get tight and you don't want that. You want your brim to be loose. So for some reason with the knit in it, it tightens it and doesn't, you know. Okay, so here's one stitch, two, three, oops, four, and then this one right here, you're going to skip. You're not going to do two together, you're just going to skip it and then go into the next one. One, two, I just pulled you yarn. Don't act like this. And the stitches do get close together, so make sure, you know, you're following along. And then four, and then skip. So you're going to skip this one and go on to the next one. So I'm going to do this the whole way around until I get to my last couple stitches, because you're not going to have even, so then I'm going to show you what I do at the last couple, and yeah, so I'll see you back when I have this going the whole way around. Okay, so here I am, and I just did four stitches, and now I'm going to have to skip, and then I'm going to have one, two, three. So I'm going to skip that one. I'm going to go into the next two, and then that last one, skip, and then just slip stitch into that stitch. So at this point, it's going to look really wonky like this. It's going to look like, oh boy, that's going to come out weird. But I promise you, it doesn't. It comes all together. It's just because your knitting stitches, your knitted stitches are tight. So they're like really, you know, close together. And so now you just separated them. So that's why it's going to look like this. But as you keep going, it comes together and, you know, lays flat and everything and looks really, really, really nice. So now we're going to chain up two. One, two. This is our chain up. Does not count as a stitch. Well, it is going to count, like, I guess it counts as a stitch, but you don't, you just slip stitch into here. But you count this as like a back post. I think you're going to have like a front post, and this will be your back post. You'll see as we go around. So now you're going to front post double crochet around that first single crochet. And now back post. And then front post. I told you this is really, really simple. Like, it's just beyond simple. Back post. So all it is front post, back post, front post, back post. There are other brims that you can do. And if you want to, you can go ahead. This is the one that just, I think, looks really, really nice. And it just gives you like a chunky vibe and just flips over nicely. But there are other ones that I want to try. And so I'm going to, as I do it, I'll pop on here and show you and, you know, show you how I did it too. On a Whip It With Me Wednesday. What did I say? Did I say Whip It With Me or Let's Whip It? I forget. But so all I'm doing is going around front post, back post, and look how nice that looks all together. So that's all you do. You just go around for as many rows as you want. Front post, back post, front post, back post, front post, back post. I'll finish this round, and then when I get back to here, I'll show you how, like, slip stitch and then, you know, go around again. And then that's it. You do it as many rounds as you want. Or rows. Yeah, rows as you want. I always, like, measure it, like, halfway up the hat so you get, like, a nice, thick brim. Oh, it's so nice. And then you could put fur around it or whatever else. So let me do this, and then I'm going to show you two headbands that I made, and I added fur around. That's really simple and easy. that you can, you know, detail. So let me finish this round and I'll get back to you in a hoot. Okay, so I went the whole way around. My last stitch was a back post, and then you're just going to slip stitch into that chain up, and that's it. So yeah, your chain up does not count as a stitch. It would just look like a back post with this one. I'll show you, but as you can see, now the wonkiness is starting to go away and it's starting to form your brim. It will look, you know, wider, and like I said, that's because your knitted stitches are knitted tight together, and so when you loosen, you're breaking the stitches apart. You're not having them be so tight anymore, and you're adding your crochet to it, so it's going to be like that. But I promise you, you saw my hat, it comes together. So let me show you this one. Okay, so as you can see here, see, that's the back of the hat, but you can't really see that. It just looks like a back post, so it comes together nicely. So you're just gonna go up, let me zoom out, as many times as you want to. This is what it looks like. See how it comes together? It doesn't look so like bowed outwards. It just comes together nicely. So you're just gonna go as many rows as you want. It depends on how thick you want yours to be or what kind of yarn you're using. So this was a thicker yarn, and I want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I did 8 rows. I do remember this one. I did 8. And so it just gives you like a nice... Do I have my thingy here? I don't have my measuring tape. I need to get organized. Again. But anyway, you can, you know, it doesn't matter. It's up to you how thick or thin you want your brim to be, and then that's it. Now, I like the hat peeping through at the bottom. Now, you don't have to have that. You could tuck it under like that more, and it looks really, really cute. Look how cute that is. So, I'm not going to finish this with you. I just wanted to show you how you can get started and what you do, because it's that's it. It's simple. You just crochet. Now, I do start off with single crochet only because you get like that nice little line. Rather than doing double crochets, it just looks more put together, and then it gives you this for when you flip it up. That single crochet gives you that lip to flip it up, where the double crochet wouldn't, because it would be bulky, because the double crochet would be right there and it wouldn't do that right. So anyway, that's it. And as you can see, it looks like that, but then the more and more it comes together, it's not, and then you can flip it up and it's going to look nice. So you can use whatever yarn that you have that you're making your hats with. This just gives you a whole new look to your machine knit hats. I'm really hoping you like my new idea that I have, and I hope, you know, it keeps you busy. So I'm going to show you, let me put this to the side right here because I'm going to finish that. Two of knitted headbands that I did, again, on the machine. So, this is just a knitted headband, and I don't know if you did the twist thing before, but you have two ends, and then you just put it together like this, and then you just sew it like that together, and then, see, you sew it together, and then it gives you, like, this little twisted look. And then what I did was, oh, I gotta cut that end. So what I did was, I went in here with the fur, and then I went the whole way around, and then to right there, and then again I went over here in here with the fur, and then the whole way around to right there. And yeah, I gotta sew that in, and then that's what this one, so pretty. And then if you wanted, you can, you know, fancy it up even more and put your little tag right there, you know, like Handmade or whatever your little name is, you know, the little thinner tags, not the big ones. So then there's that one, and this is Big Twist. And Big Twist, oh my goodness, another dream yarn, like Big Twist value, which is always on sale at Joann's. It's like, you know, $2 and some change for a skein. You can make a lot of hats out of one skein or a lot of headbands, and it knits up like a dream. I'm telling you, it really does. And then, I don't know what it is. Well, it is. It's true. Knitting and crochet, you get two completely different fabrics. So I love my Big Twist. I do. And I love crocheting with it. But then when I started knitting on the machine, I thought, oh my goodness. Like, this is a whole new ballgame for me. It is so stretchy. And it really, like, I don't know what it does with the fibers, but it makes it even softer. And it's not really rough. Like, it's not like a, Red Heart Super Saver yarn, you know, that roughness. No, their Big Twist value is actually soft, but this one is so soft. So there's that one. This one is a Hobby Lobby yarn, tweed. I love this tweed, I want to say, or I know it's a I Love This yarn, but it has like little specks in it. So that's again that little twist that I told you about, and then I just went in between again. Oh, look at that. Maybe that's why these are on my table. I gotta weave them in. But anyway, you go the whole way around, and then again the whole way around, and then you just get these. And these are so cute. Oh, I love this. I really, and this is really stretchy too. Some yarns, I am gonna say, it just didn't give stretch, and so yeah, you have to be careful because some yarns does not do, whatever. It doesn't give stretch. So yeah, that is what I have for today. I truly hope you like this little tidbit and you know, let your creative juices flow strong. That sounded weird, but just go with the flow, think outside your box, and bring your hats even more to life. Because like I said, it's not that the knitted hats on the machines aren't really beautiful, because they are. They really, really are. And you know, you could do like I said, you could flip up the brim and everything like that. But these just really, I'm really loving this. And look how it just gives like this hat a whole new look. A whole new look. I just love it. I really love this one. I don't know. I wanted to do like hello with the little rainbow. You know that thing everybody loves. But here's another example of your, oh my goodness, your slip stitch. So it really truly does just look like a back post. So, but you, of course, you can put this in the back. But I'm just saying it, when spreaded, it looks like a back post. So you don't have to worry about that at all, which I love. But oh, this one, I just love them all. So have fun. Please, if you do make them, tag me, because I would really love to see them. You could tag me on Instagram at jmck3084. I'll try to have that below for you, my Instagram, or you can even message me at gmail.com. That's jmck3084 at gmail.com. Again, I'll try to remember to put that in the bottom, so that way, you can show me your pictures, because I would truly love to see. This really is just a whole new ball game for these hats. And you could do them for guys and girls too. Like, these are the ones that I'm making for women. You can make them for kids too. I have a really cute idea that I want to do for the kids. So I'm going to show that once I, you know, come together and get it done. But you could do it for the guys too, because guys like the thicker brim. So especially those who are like out, that are hunters or working, you know, they like to keep extra warm. So you could do the same exact thing here, just in manly colors if they don't like the pinks. So, yep, that's it. Hope you like this video, and hope you're all having a hooterific day. Hoonting out. Bye.